Previously on Gumball 3000.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day,
Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely.
What if my wrist had a pretty out of mall? Would it make me ball? Well, I guess I'm stuntin', but I've been doing that. I ain't even know. R.I.P. to my new double R. With the suicide dolls, I'm froze. My girl got a girl too. FMG, shout out to Pooh. DJ Friends, Molly Mar, Jazz Lays, and the whole crew. Five Phantom stacked back to back. Two Camaros, one Maybach. Obviously, we got racks on racks. Please do not bother asking that. Red bottoms all on my feet. Playing ball in my new Yeezys. Hopping out of white AMGs. What you gon' do? What if my wallet? What you gon' do about it? What if my chauffeur pulled up in the ghost with a two-tone body? What if my mansion is on top of the mountain, looking down on y'all? What if my wrist has a pretty out of mall? Would it make me ball when I take that ball? Ball, ball so hard, ball, ball so hard. I tell why. Ball, ball so hard, ball, ball so hard. I tell ball, ball, ball so hard, ball, ball so hard. Now watch me ball, ball, ball so hard, ball, ball so hard.
So we're on day five, if you can believe it. We set off from Dublin last Sunday, which seems about 3 weeks away. We've gone through like so many countries, so many everything, great parties. London is just like phenomenal. And now here we are in Czech Republic in Prague, great, great reception again. And we're driving to Budapest right now with a lunch stop at the famous Hungaroring racetrack. So all good, looking forward to it.
With Team 18, we drove to Germany, and it's from some kind of reason it's not allowed to have a chrome wrapped car in Germany. And he said, do something about it.
Germany was just trying to, you know, pull rabbits out of their ass, trying to find a reason.
Exactly.
Yeah. To give guys money and to basically try to break us as human beings. And his problem was his car looked too good. His car was literally too clean and too shiny to drive through Germany in the sunlight.
I think the police guy, he saw his own face and he thought, oh, do something about it.
Yeah. I don't want to see this in Germany anymore, but that was his face he was talking about. This is what a lot of gumballs, you notice, everybody just jumped up and left. Because a lot of these car dudes, they car dudes. They want to get out on the track and burn rubber and all that shit. I just want to get on the highway and just enjoy the sights and the views. I get up my little speed on the interstate or whatever, but I'm not worried about no racetrack. So we got 5 hours, we rolling out and it's going down.
Good morning. Got my coffee in my hand. We're in Prague right now. We're on our way to the lunch stop before we get to Budapest. Today is a short drive, thankfully, for a lot of people that went out last night. I didn't, so I'm feeling good, but see you on the other side. Peace.
About not quitting, and it's about not giving up, and about Like I, that's why I was telling everybody in the lobby. That's why they was mad at me this morning, because I went around to everybody. I was like, you know, if you don't go to the club, the Germans won. We have to party tonight, because if we don't party, the Germans win. They try to break us. And went dead to sleep. I made sure every motherfucker in that lobby was like, fuck me, you're right, man. We gotta go. It's fucking, the guy say, man, they try to break us mentally. They try to break us emotionally. They tried to take our money financially. They did everything they could so that we would get here and be like, fuck these cars and fuck Gumball and all that. But no, fuck y'all.
Yeah, I'm Brandon Adams. I'm with Team 85. There's three of us here. We're all from Texas, so yeah, we're driving the Dodge Hellcat. It's been a blast. Everyone's like to see the American muscle, and so it's nice to bring something completely different to the scene. So this is it. We'll see where we end up.
Well, I think, you know, Gumball is about a lot of people meeting up from different countries, backgrounds, religion, color, having fun, joining up, learning, teaching each other about cars, about culture, religion, you name it. I think the world should be a little bit more like the Gumball Inspiration too.
What's up, man? It's Chris Massey from Zoe 101 on Nickelodeon. I'm out here with my boy Zach.
What's up? You know,
we turning up
here.
Gumball 3000, Bun B, Trill Team, Texas. We out here. Woo!
Girls,
let's get it.
Cars, more cars.
Hey, 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 hey.
Oh yeah, this is how my dream started. Put your hands in the air while I get it started. Cause I know I should've took your advice. Don't waste another second or another minute of your time. Oh yeah, this is how my dream started. Put your hands in the air while I get it started. Cause I know I should've took your advice. Don't waste another second or another minute of your time.
I went from bankrupt to having black cards, to having six flags sitting in my backyard. So salute to who's still chasing a dream. I know it always ain't what it seems.
It was fantastic. I'm home. This is holy ground for me, man. And look, we might even have some dry asphalt. God is playing ball. I think so, anyway.
Alright, we're in Hungary right now. We're at the Hunger Roaring F1 track. It's a lunch stop for the day, and if guys want to race, they can get out there. They can put their car on the track. I think they got some other cars in the track. I don't know. I just got here, so I just want to see what they got going. And grab some lunch right quick and see what they do.
Our biggest priority is the fans. Of course, the other Gumballers want to give everybody a great time. Hungaroring is obviously one of the best racetracks in the world. It's a proper Formula One circuit. They do the GP here every year.
So the car we're driving for the trip is a car I was really reluctant to bring. There's only going to be 799 of them produced. It's called the Ferrari F12 TDF. TDF stands for Tour de France. The Tour de France is 100 kilograms lighter. It's got almost 800 horsepower, and it's one of the most sought-after cars there are. The car is 380,000 euros to buy. Right now, on the black market, people are paying over €1 million for them.
This is for my people out to ball it hard. Spending stupid cash, we don't got no cars. 5, 10s, 20s, 50s, and them 100s, man. Sorry for you haters, you don't understand. This is for my people who be balling hard. Spending stupid cash, we don't got no cars. 5, 10s, 20s, 50s, and them 100s, man.
Man, this is the greatest experience of my life, hands down. I got to meet Bun B, the coolest dude ever. Got to race on the track. Oh, we got to see the fucking amazing Batmobile. And then there's some sexy ladies here as well. What's up, ladies?
Hey, ladies.
What's up?
Hey.
Beyond cool. I mean, I don't even, it's so easy to drive. For a single seater, you know, formula car, it's great. It's America.
Well, if we're going and driving a Batmobile to that, I mean,
at this point, I don't know what's left. What's there's left to drive? What else can I drive?
Well, the cool thing about this car is that you can drive it a track like this, Hungaroring, Budapest,
right.
And you can have such amazing time with the car. It's faster than anything else that's here. And then you can drive it home. You can drive it on the road, drive it around LA, drive it around the streets of the US. The thing's road legal. So that's the whole USP about the whole car.
Yeah, I definitely think that if I drove up in that, the women would definitely be loving me that night. I just have a feeling. I don't know. Maybe it's just me.
About to get on
in this mono. Very fly car.
I'm a hero or a villain, I still can't decide. Feel like every single thought I've been switching sides. Power, drunk off the power, I think it's clouding my vision. Power, drunk off the power, look at the voice I've been given. Power, drunk off the power. Stop popping bottles of that, stop tripping on tracks. Let's celebrate for the night, let's celebrate where we at.
If you don't have one of these, you need one of these ASAP. This car is so fun to drive, and it's so fast. Amazing. My brother's back in town to the ATL. It'd be a wrap.
Hey,
like, everywhere I go, it would be a movie. Every day. Everywhere I went.
Like, the real thing about Gumball is, like, people don't realize how much of an endurance test Gumball 3000 is. It's a physical endurance test. It's a mental endurance test, right? All of the senses have to be in tune. Hand, eye, foot coordination has to be in tune.
This shit, it's
not easy. It's not always fun. This shit can be very brutal. And if you ain't in sync with the person or the people you in the car with, man, this shit can be miserable. It's not fun getting pulled over every 15, 20 fucking minutes, snatched out your car, people getting tickets for having sunglasses on, for having one shoe on, like, dumb shit. It's a lot of bullshit. And motherfuckers just keep going. We do more shit in one day than most people do in a month. Like, you know, going to Prague, going to Dublin, going to Scotland, going to London, going to Budapest. Those are vacations for most people. That's like a 3-5 week vacation for most people. We're only in these cities for like 8 hours. We stay in 5-star hotels and touch the bed for maybe 5 hours total, if you're lucky. We be in these cars driving, pushing. But that's the payoff. Very few people will get to say that they did anything that we did at any part of one of these days. We're finna go to a racetrack and do donuts and all kind of dumb shit. We're gonna have a state dinner in the state building. Like, not just an official state dinner, black tie. This ain't no small bullshit. We drove cars into amusement parks. We've been on ferries. I'd have been on 2 trains, 2 boats, and a plane, and I already drove about 2,000 miles. This shit ain't no joke. And money ain't gonna help you. You gotta be built a certain way to do this shit. You don't just get to do Gumball. We gotta let you do Gumball. Then when we let you do Gumball, we gotta walk you through this motherfucker. But then you can say you survived. And you get the t-shirt.
The banister yesterday at the grid, and I went to save the baby and I tripped and broke my ankle.
But it's all about the people.
It's all about the people, you know?
Budapest. We in some type of square. We at the grid. It's crazy out here. I've never seen it like this. Out of control. Budapest really came out and showed love.
Man, Bun B was whipping out there, bro. He's true for real, behind the wheel. I thought it was a professional driver or something, like, because he was cutting. I was like, yo, whoever's in that range, he's going ham. And of course, it would be Bun. That shit was like, for real.
It's been crazy. It's been, there's been ups and downs. Obviously no sleep, and you know, my motto in life is race, rave, repeat, and this is definitely one of those race, rave, repeat weeks. And I met some awesome people, and I think what I really love about it is, you know, everybody's in a similar mindset, and it's like a big family that comes together, and everybody sort of adopts each other and takes care of each other and watches out for each other on the road as well, which is awesome.
I mean, we want to be ready for tomorrow.
Yeah.
For, Spirit of the Gumball. Outfit on.
You know it.
It's the only gumball machine I've ever seen. Only takes hundreds. It's crazy.
Life is cool, they never taught ya. Dreams of my own. I've been working from home. I can do it on my own, but sometimes it gets cold like.
The next morning.
I gotta charge it for a week, man. Well, good, that's gonna do this.
What's that,
bro? Oh, there's the fucking key to my mini GP. I've looked at this bag already 100 times. Oh, okay. I know it's not in here.
This is a
snap. Well, we do. We called him. He said that there's no way. So we're kind of going through a crisis right now. We lost the key of the Batmobile.
See you next week on Gumball 3000.